So hey guys, and welcome back to another video and to the first episode of our FIFA 21 Everton career mode. Feels good to say that. I've been waiting quite a bit to start it, and now very exciting this one because I've played a bit of the FIFA just to get used to it, and I feel like it's much better than last year's. I just really didn't enjoy last year's really, but this year's I'm enjoying quite a bit. And let me just get rid of all these or this stuff. Quite a lot, not a lot, but a couple of new features that are quite good. In career mode, ultimate team, and all that, etc. This year, so hopefully going forward, they can continue to build on that. The PES 21 career mode will start pretty soon. At the time of recording, tomorrow the patch gets released where like all the transfers will be complete, so I'll start it after that. I've been waiting for that. Now, quick disclaimer, unfortunately at the time of recording, Wednesday the 21st of October I think it is, the tickets still haven't been released in FIFA, which is a bit of a... Yeah, it's a bit of a pain. You'd expect EA to have the tickets in the game. Unfortunately, they're not. Hopefully, by next episode, they will. But this episode, it won't be a lot of... I don't even think we'll have any gameplay in it. This episode is going to be solely focused on just getting it started and getting a couple of transfer and loan deals done with Everton. Of course, the new features are the new training, which is fantastic. Before I started the episode, I went through, put three drills on, I played them all, got, I got C, B, and B, or C, B, A, or something like that. So, I can now sim those and get the best grades. Of course, we have got the preloaded Youth Academy. I did buy the Champions Edition, so I should have a homegrown youth player. But, apparently they're meant to start at 75 overall. I don't see that here. I think this guy might be him. No, he's from Paraguay. I don't know. I don't know. Yeah. But this is basically our Youth Academy. It's pretty bad right now. Even this fella, this Polish kid, not that good. Probably our best one, Delgado from Paraguay. Potential 72 to 94. 57 rated. Get him in a bit of training, I guess. Of course, you can see I've got 97 million. I must admit, I did add a financial takeover because I have recorded an episode of this already. I just didn't really enjoy it. Unfortunately, I felt I could do better. And so, from that episode, I took that I needed a bit more money for the players I want to bring in. A couple of them are quite expensive, and you know, it's career mode. I can go over the top of it. Now, I've already made the formation. It's a 4-3-3 defense. Still with that cam though. As you can see, Olsen in net. Of course, if you could tell by the time of recording, the derby's already happened. The whole controversy with Pickford, I'm not getting into it. It's whatever, it's happened. But Olsen in net. Lucadinho left back. Keane, Holgate, Coleman, the Decoy, Alan, Rodriguez, Richarlison, Bernard for now will get replaced though. Well, Richarlison to move over. We're planning on getting the left winger. And Calvert-Lewin up top. There's our second team with Pickford him. Now, I don't know whether to sell Pickford or not. He's still a pretty good keeper, but I have a keeper that I want to bring in as our main keeper for a year or two. And of course, Olsen's only on loan, but depending on how good he is, I could bring him back maybe on a loan with an option to buy or a permanent deal next season from Roma. But yeah, apart from that, and I have put development plans on a couple of players, Bernard to become a cam, or Obi to become a cam role just for backup to James Rodriguez. So yeah, I think that's all I need to tell you. The Youth Academy, done the training, done the development. We just need to sit ahead in this preseason tournament, and hopefully we should get a couple of deals. And I have also went through and put a couple of people on the loan and transfer list. Hey boss, I'm a bit surprised you're looking me to move wrong, but I can't say I'm unhappy with it. Yeah, I'm looking at options, Pickford. You might be getting taken off that list. pretty soon. I don't know. So, of course, if you go in here, see, I've done none of these. So, that is why I'm going to change the drill to stop the wall. No, why would I want to do this? No. Where are the players I've already done it with? Yay, Mina. Stick Ben Godfrey on there as well. And can I do Michael Keane? No, why can't I do Michael Keane? I guess we'll do the Corey. Yeah, I'm just going to do different players. I did originally have Keane, Holgate and Mina. I think. Can't remember. Yeah, there we go. Long shot. Practice. No, we're going to have James on it with Charleston, Dom and Sigurdsson on it. That's who I had on last time. An interceptor. I think I had, yeah, pass and pass to goal. This one was pretty difficult, actually. No. Yeah, we need a good pass at the centre-back. We have Holgate as well. Do Bernard. Do Allen, of course. Yeah, we may as well get a couple bench players involved. Well, one bench player. That can be Andre Gomez. So a bit of a rotation to what I did last time, but we may as well just get as many players as we can training. Now we've got to rest before our first match. Now I won't be doing the match sim thing just yet. I'm just going to quick send them. We've got a couple of scout reports. So Alan Saint-Maximin, Ross Barkley, I know he's a love-hate relationship with Everton fans. I just thought it'd be good to bring him back in the future. Jack Grealish, Calvin Phillips, Nick Pope. These are players I've just got on my shortlist right now. Phillips more just for like that backup role, maybe try and move Fabian Delph over to Leeds and swap the other four Phillips or something like that. And we get a 2-0 victory with Charlton and Allen scoring against Bologna. Ajax winning, Nice winning against Dortmund. I don't know if I put John Joe Kenny on the transfer list, but that right back position, I am looking on moving John Joe Kenny on, maybe perhaps in a swap deal with a player I have on the transfer list. Because what I've got to remember is that I've got Marcello in the youth squad, who's coming out on loan in the Netherlands, who I think would be a good right back maybe next season, start integrating. Now, Yannick Bolasie. Yeah, you can go to Ajax. I do like Bolasie. I wish he could have got back to his best, but we are going to indeed sell him on to Ajax for 4 million if he can agree terms. Dennis Boranga, Yusuf Atal, that's the player I'm looking at getting that right back in a swap deal for Kenny. Ignore some of these. Well, don't ignore them, but a couple of these I'm just, you know. Yeah, Bernard I'm going to keep until at least January. But yeah, a couple of these. Oh, Leverkusen wants Tom Davis. Sorry, I keep on getting interrupted. Yeah, he can go out on loan. Yeah, a couple of these are more either for next season or maybe just on loan with an option to buy. I do want to use that new mechanic. And now after this match against Udinese, as we get more and more scout reports back, I think I will go and try and make signings. Oh, now an offer's coming from Besiktas. I'm going to go ahead and negotiate this for Pickford. I'm sorry, Pickford, if I can get enough money for you, I am going to sell you on. In real life, of course, he's been getting this whole thing with threats and all that. It was just silly. But, see, what? What can I get? See if I can get 32. That'll take us up to 130. 21. Jeez, no. Sticking to the third one. What about 28? Bring it a bit down. Nope. Oh, come on, he's worth more than that. Besiktas, I'm not selling him for 21 million. That, you know, I think, what did we pay 35 million for him for Sunderland or something like that? I can't remember. So we'll play this match against Udinese. Should we do that? Yeah, why not? Should we just give it? I'm tempted to give the second team a run out. Yeah, let's just give them a second run out against Udinese. A 1-1 draw, Bernard with a one goal. I was going to say, Udinese not a team to underestimate. I might have underestimated them then. Oh, and by the way, in the next episode, when we get the Premier League season kicked off, we have got one hell of an opening match. That match is an away trip to Anfield to take on Liverpool. So the Merseyside derby. No, Balassi's not going there. An offer for Tucson from Hertha Berlin. Tucson? What? Tucson. Cheng Tucson, Harvey. Jeez. I can get about 6 million for him, so I'm just going to ask for 6.2 million for him of Hertha Berlin. But yeah, in the next episode when we get the Premier League started, we've got an away trip to Anfield. The Merseyside derby is our first competitive match of the season. It's just crazy. Any other save I did? I had Man City, so that was great. Away from home, 5-4. No, let's just go for 6 then. 6 million. Come on. Yep. Okay. Cheng Tosun. Fortunately, don't have a future here. The 29 Turkish striker. He can go. Hopefully, Tom Davis goes on loan to Leverkusen for a year at the Bundesliga. I think we're going to go and try and make a couple of signings with the money that we have so far. A couple might be loaned as well, and a couple might be made later on in this window. I haven't got all reports back. So, yeah, here's the players. I've got this man linked to him in real life. He was apparently about to come, and then United just blocked the offer. I want to bring him in as our main keeper for about a season or two for this season. Olsen as his backup. Kepa's on there because I want to try and bring him back to his best at Everton. Dean Henderson, these are just players I've just got to put on. Luke Ayling, I don't know why, I just am a fan of. I was planning on bringing him in to be that little gap for a year as backup to Coleman. But then I found this man, Atto, who I'm going to try and bring in a swap deal, as I said. Calvin Phillips, maybe in a swap deal for Fabian Delph as that backup, who can eventually come in and take over. Ismael Lassar, we all know how quality he is. Ross Barkley, as I said before. Adley, I just added, you know, just in case we need depth. For Fabian, I'm thinking of maybe a loan deal either in January or in the summer, like later on in this window, with an option to buy maybe. Leon Bailey, so then I do want to bring him in as that backup, and he would be backup to this man, Wilfred Zaha. I'm going to make my main priority to bring him. Yeah, and he'll be backup and then eventually overtake him. Boanga, linked with him in real life. Alan Saint-Maximin, I just really quite like Alan Saint-Maximin. Mason Mount, I'm thinking of bringing in on loan, not with an option to buy, but Chelsea do like loaning out their players, so to get him for a year as backup to James would be great. Josh King, linked with him in real life, unfortunately didn't bring him in, but I would like to bring him in. I think we will bring him in January in real life. Hudson-Odoi, again, maybe a loan from Chelsea. And then, this is not the final one. Charles Abbe, I was thinking of bringing in because we've got Moyes Keane out on loan on PSG. I know we've got Ellis Sims, but this lad, for a season, again, on loan, not with an option to buy, but on loan for one season to be back up to Calvert-Lewin, I don't think would be that bad, Charles Abbe, to compete with Ellis Sims, and then Moyes Keane can come back. And Jack Grealish has just saw before. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to try and bring in the keeper first. 6 million for Sergio Romero. Now, do I look for maybe a swap deal, or do I just pay the straight up 6 million for Sergio Romero, or do I try and get rid of a player? I'm thinking maybe Mo Besic, just to get him off the books. 1.5 plus. Should we do 4.5? Oh, are they going to walk away from this? I hope not. Are they on Ben Godfrey? No. We've only just got him. Is there any centre-backs I can go? What about Pennington? Plus 4.5. Yeah, we'll just leave the 10 on, why not? I know, they're going to walk away from this, aren't they? Oh no, 4.7 million. Damn. Managed to negotiate them down with United there. And we've got Sergio Romero for 4.7 million without Matthew Pennington going. Now we just have to try and bring him in on personal terms, a 33-year-old. I know he's 33, but in my opinion, he's a solid keeper. And we'd be good for a year or two, especially with Olsen as that backup. Squad vote. I'm going to say important. Yeah, he's going to take that. I will be starting him mostly 1 year. I would like to say 2 years and then maybe expand it. Okay, yeah, 2 years. Perfect. No release clause. Oh, I've got to offer the wages. I'm going to say 82. Slight pay rise. Yep, it's a reasonable offer. Slight pay rise only because he'll be starting for us in most of our games. So Nick Pope not coming in, sorry. Right, next person that I need to focus on bringing in. I'm thinking this lad. Oh, okay, the club just isn't interested in loaning him out. No. Okay, I might have to wait till later on the window. Whoa, I just stuttered on my words there. Later on in the window or the January transfer window is what I was trying to say. Do we go and slash the cast on Zaha? Do we go and bring him in right now? I don't know what to do. Well, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go put a Sergio Romero in for Olsen. And Pickford, I'm sorry, mate, but you drop him to the bench. We're going to try and sell you on just in this career mode. You haven't got a place in real life. If you can start to get back into form, I'm sure you'll have a place. But, you know, yeah. Right. I'm going to go in for this Atal. Yusuf Atal. I'm going to try and get him. Swap deal for John Joe Kenny. If I can, to go to Nice. Fullbacks. No, not Lucas Digne. 9.5, that's pretty good. What if I offer 10 mil on top of that? John Joe Kenny plus 10 mil. Ooh, Andre Gomez. No, I'd rather exchange another player. This is hard, this. Wingers? Is there any wingers I can let go of? Maybe Balassi? Plus... remove the sell-on clause. A new transfer fee. Drop that down to maybe... 14.5. Oh my god, I didn't realise he'd walk on. I thought they'd like renegotiate it. Okay, Atal's not coming in for now. Till at least later on in this window. I don't know if it's going for Zaha or not. Oh, we may as well just go and try and splash the cash now while we've got it. And then we've got the rest of the cash to look at later on in the window. Or later on and even in this episode. Right, let's go, boy. I know I keep on using this swap feature, but I need to get some players out. And it's a good way of just having, you know, bringing the price down on certain players. A player that they wanted in real life, of course, got injured, unfortunately. Cenk Tosun. Why don't you take him? Plus 30 million. Because Wilfred Zaha is a class player, in my opinion. So, Tosun pays that extra 5. And that 39. No. If you want me to pay 39, you're not getting Tosun on top of it. Because, yeah. Drop that down. To that, remove the player. 32 million for Zaha. 44. No. It's too expensive for me. 36. Come on. 36 for Zaha. 44. They're sticking to that 44 price tag, aren't they? Fine, 38. We're going more to what he originally wanted. Okay. I'll pay 40. 40 million. We'll take some time to think about it. Zaha is such a pain to get in FIFA. Um. Yeah, we're gonna go and get Josh King, I think. Yeah. Yeah, let's just go get Josh King in as that backup, just to have him ready. I wanna preferably have all these players that I really, really want in for the derby. Let's see, will player swap work here? Mo Bezic plus six and a half. Ooh, they want Cheng Tosun plus 5.4. Tosun's older. Can I bring this price tag down to 4.8? I'm just going to be dead cheeky and say, can I bring it down? And you can have Cheng Tosun on top of it. There we go. That's a more realistic offer. I brought your price down, but then Cheng Tosun going to the championship. Not an awful move for him. You know, he might do quite well down there and then get a move for Cheng Tosun. I reckon he will do quite good in the championship. Oh, he's on such low wage as well. Yeah, we'll do him as important. He'll be our backup striker, left and right winger. 4 years? Is he going to take four? He wants two. All right, meet you in the middle, three. Maybe try and extend that. Oh, I almost just ended the negotiation. Yeah, I don't want to release clause on him. Woo, he wants a massive pay rise. 5 goals. Oh, we have the money. Why not? Welcome on second signing, Josh King. Romero and King in so far. On top of course, James Rodriguez, Allen, Decoy, Godfrey, Olsen. So let's bring him straight up to the bench. Who do we bring him on for? I'm thinking we're going to drop Sigurdsson down, unfortunately. So, Sigurdsson and Pickford, I mean... Sigurdsson I've got a love-hate relationship with. But... See, it really depends, man. If you get an offer for Sigurdsson, a good enough one, I think I'm looking for if I can use him in a swap deal. He's worth quite a bit. Again, I'll have a look. I don't know. I have to see. I don't know, man. No, why does it always put these players on there? Can I put Michael Keane on it? Why can't I? It's just annoying. Oh, I know. I don't know why I'm asking. I know why. It's because I want other stuff. That's right, we can rotate anyway. It's change. Yeah, pass the goal, but it's not going to be these, is it? It'll be Allen, Keane, you know, Holgate can go in, and Gomez can go in. I just like having centre backs that can get the ball out quick. And in between episodes, I will do more of them, so I'm not just picking the same ones. Oh, I can get a fourth? Damn. Alright then, King, go ahead. Simulate all. There we go. Josh King on his first training session at Finch Farm. So we'll play this match against Celta. Mason Mount, Angus Gunn, Henderson, Kepa, Callum Hudson-Odoi, Zaha. They're on 43.3. I won't be paying. Oh, actually. Let me just play this match against Celta and then I'll have a look. Tom Davis has went out to buy Leverkusen. That'll be good. A year in the Bundesliga for him. Against Celta, we're going to put out our main team. Sergio Romero gets the first start in goal. And it's a 1-0 victory. James with the goal. Josh King came on for Bernard on that right-hand side. So he got a bit of a debut. But James Rodriguez with our goal. One and only goal against Celta. Oh, and we're through to the semis, and it's against Borussia Dortmund, and interest has been shown in Leon Bailey from Napoli. No. Napoli are not seeing on up. He's my player. I am taking Leon Bailey. We'll come back to him. Leon Bailey, we're going to go and try and steal from Napoli. Player we were linked with in real life. I wish we kind of got him. Would they be willing to do a player? Yeah, swap. With who, though? With who? Maybe Gylfi. Gylfi, I'm sorry, mate, but... you might have to go. If I give you Gylfi Sigurdsson plus 15 million, that makes 30 million. 29. Oh, significantly cheaper than what Napoli offered. I think they offered 37. That's a more realistic offer. 24.5 million plus Gylfi Sigurdsson. Leon Bailey, a real, real quality player we could be bringing in here. From Leverkusen. Sorry if you can hear my PS in the background. That's important. Perfect, yeah. He knows he won't be getting a start in place immediately. 4 years. Perfect. No release clause. 49.5. 20 appearances. Welcome to the club, Leon Bailey. We have the money to do it. Why not? He's a quality player. It will be good for our future. 43.3 million for Zaha. I'm thinking of just paying it. Yeah, let's just pay it. Zaha is our last main player we want in. We can make more money from selling players. There's still a long time left in the window. We can make money back from selling the players. And Zaha is a class player to bring in. Crucial, yeah, he will be. He'll be starting for us. I'm going to try 4 years. Oh, he's actually accepted. Yeah, that's fine. No release clause. Can you tell me his wages? Okay. Nope. What we'll do then, is because I assume Zaha would just be like, I want a pay rise. Let's just put him up to 90. I don't know. I'm panicking here. Yep. It's a reasonable offer. And that 43.3 million, I think I've just seen, that take us down to 20 million? Yep. 20 million left in the budget. But quite a good window so far. What we're going to do is we're going to move Richarlison over to the left. Bernard on the bench. Delph won't be playing on the left, don't worry. Delph is just going to drop all the way to the reserves. For Zaha, Bailey will jump up. For Iwobi. Iwobi can jump up here for Balassi. Sorry, Iwobi, but that's how it goes. Go for Zaha on that left-hand side. And I guess we progress. And also the tournament prize money that we get in this tournament, if we can make it to the final. I mean, past Dortmund, so it's going to be really, really difficult. But come on, lads, we can do this. We can beat Dortmund. Come on, they've got Haaland up front, I just realised. Oh my God, we actually beat them. Richarlison with a 70th minute goal. Haaland got one back for them. Richarlison with the two in the fourth minute. 2-1 win. And we'll be taking on Ajax in the final. Haaland getting one back for them past Romero. But a 2-1 victory. That is massive for us to get through to the final. And there's another 3.3 million. Bezic could be going for 1.5 million. Yep. So slowly making our money back in it. Players I want to go in for now, hopefully with maybe trade deals or loans, shouldn't cost too much really, and especially since we just got a John Joe Kenny offer of 11 million, no, I'm going to turn that down for the pure fact I'd like to probably use him in a swap deal for Yusuf Atal. Right, come on, let's just get this friendly done, well this final done against Ajax. Holgate transfer offer from Atalanta, no way. You are taking him, he is my main starting centre-back. Of course, it's said that he's out in real life, hopefully he comes back even better than he was last season. But Ajax in the final. Angers want to take Benny Beningame to the French League. No option to buy. Go ahead, you take Benny Beningame to Ligue 1. Yeah, well, may as well just put out a full-strength starting 11 against them. Oh, they got Promes, he's a pain in this game. Blinder's their captain, come on, lads, come on. Oh, we beat them on penalties 4-3. So the game ended 0-0. I'll take you through the... I know you've just seen the stats, but Holgate got a yellow card. They made three changes. We brought King on for Richarlison. We got taken to penalties. James misses. Promes scores. King scored his. David Carson from Everton player missed his. Cavallone scored. Anthony scored for them. Zaha missed. Kudos scored. Digne scored. Traore missed. Decoy missed. Alvarez missed. Jesus. Allen scored. And they missed. Everton win 4-3 on penalties against Ajax to win the preseason tournament. That gets us quite a bit of money, hopefully, to bring in those last few players that we need. My goodness. 3.6 million, not awful, you know. Probably enough to bring in those players that we won. Josh King disappointed with... What? Leicester want Yeremina? No. Yeremina staying for at least this one season. I really like Yeremina in real life and in this game. No, what we're going to do is we're going to change them back to our normal ones. This is kind of a pain. I should probably just set this to normal. We're going to put Zaha, James, Keane, Holgate, and Decore on. That. Stop the wall. Yes. Ben Godfrey, we'll do Allen. We'll do Digne. Why not? We'll do Andre Gomez. Oh no, we can't. We'll just do them three then. Shot some more angles. Why does that have Yeremina on it? Richarlison, Dom, King, Bailey. There we go. Another day of training done after winning the preseason tournament. 4-3 on penalties against Ajax. Jeez. How much have we got left? We've got 27 million. Let's say get 5 away wins this whole season. Should be able to do that, surely. Okay then. I'm gonna see if they wanna. Oh, why don't anybody wanna loan them? God damn it. Alright, we're gonna go in one more time for Atal. If we can't get him, then it's whatever. I guess I'll just have to use John Joe Kenny for this one season. Pullbacks. John Joe Kenny. See, this is where I've got to be careful now. 10 million? 15 and a half. No. We might have to wait for Atal to at least January. Not at least January. Might just have to wait till either later on this window or January. Yeah, I don't know how I'm going to get him, unfortunately. Let's just sim ahead, see if we get any transfer offers coming in. Michael Keane, Spurs, you know, another player I have to keep. Because he's so good in real life right now, and in this game, I enjoy using all our centre-backs. Right, come on, big chance to offer come in. Bernard, Beningamy's went out. Bernard could be going to Leverkusen. Do I accept 15 million for Bernard? I don't really want to let the little Brazilian go because I do really like him. No, he's staying at least this one season. Come on, come in for one of my players I'm not going to use that much and I'm willing to actually sell. Maybe I go in for Calvin Phillips, sorry, as the last player or the last signing of this episode. Joe Virginia, 2-year loan offer. No option to buy, go ahead. You can go out on loan, especially since you've got quite a good amount of keepers. That player that I need to go, unfortunately, is Pickford. He'll get me quite a lot of money. Probably enough to bring in Calvin Phillips, Atal, and maybe just one more. Oh yeah, I've got an offer for Awobi. It's doing well. They've offered me Alan Cresswell. No. I probably should have went in for like one of their good players. Like Declan Rice or something like that. No, whatever. We don't need Rice. We've got Alan and Decore. But I could have went in for like one of their really good players. That might have been a little bit of a mistake. I could have tried to renegotiate. Joe Virginia's gone out. Offer from Borussia Mönchengladbach for Fabian Delph, 8 million. Now, I know I'm going to seem crazy rejecting that, but I'm going to go in for Calvin Phillips. That's going to be our last action of this episode before next episode when we'll try and bring in a couple more players. But we're going to try and swap Fabian Delph for Calvin Phillips here. Come on. Please, 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 please. Marcelo Bielsa. Midfielders. Fabian Delph. Plus 6.5. I know Phillips is quite a good player. That Leeds won't want to get rid of. 11. We can most certainly bring that down. 15% sell on clause. Yeah, that's fine. I probably will end up selling them on in the future, unfortunately. But 8.5. 12. I'm just going to be really cheeky and say 9.5 for Phillips plus Fabian Delph. That's pretty good. They keep on just going up. Okay then, we'll just go right on the dot. 10 million. Yep. 10 million, 15% selling clause plus Fabian Delph for Calvin Phillips. That's a pretty good transfer done there. We still got 18 million to spend and we still got all this transfer window to sell players rotation. Perfect. Yeah, we still got all of this window to sell players on, make more money. 42. Yeah. Calvin Phillips is another signing that we make. I know it looks like I'm just throwing money everywhere, but you know, I can make this money back. So that's where we're going to end it. So let's have a look at our brand new signings then. Phillips can come up to the bench for... See, this is the competition, this. Ben Godfrey. Godfrey can come up here. For Branthwaite. Branthwaite can go up there for Bezic. Right. So in our main team, we made the signings of Sergio Romero, Wilfred Zaha, Josh King, Leon Bailey, and Calvin Phillips. That's a very good start to this career mode. Romero, Zaha, Bailey, King, Phillips in. Hopefully next episode we can try and get Atal if we can late on in the window. And who else can we try and get? I will change squad numbers in between episodes as well, by the way. And I guess we can try and go in for maybe Fabian late on loan with an option to buy maybe. Yeah, and that looks like the only two deals I kind of want to get done. For next episode, Fabian or Fabian, whatever you want to say, Fabian, I'll call him. Fabian and Atal, both into the club, hopefully, next episode. But yeah, thank you very much for watching this first episode of our FIFA 21 Everton career mode. Pez 1 should start up soon. And yeah, be sure to tune into the next one when we have Liverpool away from home at Anfield to kick off our Premier League season. Thank you very much for watching, and yeah, bye-bye.